In the previous videos, we saw the value expression and for expression, the simple one. Now we'll look into move corresponding. Earlier, move corresponding was there in ABAP, but it was between work areas. With 7.4, you can move corresponding fields of internal tables to another internal table where the field name is same. And also in this example, we'll do a complex for operator and also a value operator where we will loop through two different tables using a for loop and then doing a value expression to populate a table. So this is a more practical scenario. Let's check this out. So as usual, we have commented the previous code and then we'll try to define a type. Say types, we'll say begin of typo and then we'll give end of typo and then we'll define some fields, ebln type ebln, and we'll give lifnar type lifnar. And what else we can give, say we'll give the same example, we had a filter risk type flag, right? And then we'll define we forgot a comma here. Then we'll define a data, I'll say itab type standard table of typo. All right, now let's select something from two different tables. So I'll say select ebln and eblp and b, so let's any twr, and then we'll do a case for the risk one. So when any twr is greater than 1000, then this is the x. All right, else let it be blank. All right, and then and as, so what do you want this field name to be? I want this field name to be risk. Then we can, for MATNR, we can select MATNR, anything, MAT, NR, or works, whatever you want, select from the whatever is available, up to 10 rows. You may not do this, but because I know my table has only 14 records, so it won't have performance issue. But if your work, if your data table in the data are too much, then you always want to restrict it for now. Into table, at the rate, we'll declare a inline table. So I'll name it as li item. Okay, so this is good. Why is crying? Okay, for OM. Alright, are we good now? Again, I gave a full stop here. So full stop should be here. Okay, so this works. Now let's select one more data from one more table so that we can do move corresponding and see that. So we'll select from header this time. Select ebln, then lfnr, because the final table has lifnar. So let's select that too. Up to 10 rows again, from ekko into table previously at the rate data, we'll escape the host variables li head. Okay, so I think so we have data from two different tables. Now let's try to move corresponding. So corresponding li, I'll move the item tables item to item. So what I'm doing, the item table has ebln, eblp, netwr, risk, then matner, works. So, and I want to move all the data from li item to itab, but what will move? Itab has only ebln, lifnar, and risk. So of all these fields, only ebln, then, and risk, these two will move to this table. All right. So we can see, or we can use our class method to display it also. So I'll just copy paste this guy here, and copy paste this guy so that we can see the output real time. Alright, so let's copy this, I activated this, and now let's test it. So check the output. So the ebln and risk were common in the final table, which is also there in the li item table, so those data moved directly. You see the code, we did not loop or anything, we just did move corresponding. The same thing we can do with the header too. So let me close this and let me put move corresponding from header. Okay, so I'll just say move corresponding head, head from the header. So let me activate this and test it. Check the output. So the header had ebln, lifnar, and EBL and Lifner, but no risks. So only the EBL and Lifner are moved. So if you see the data here, and the header had, what do you have? EBL and Lifner. So only EBL and Lifner are moved. So this way, we can move directly using move correspondings. But this might not be the real case. In real case, you might want to loop to different data and do it. So what will happen if I have both of them active? So both of them. So I do first a move corresponding to li item and then move corresponding li header to I tab. So let's check this out. What do you think? Okay, let's check it out. So look at the output. The first date value, the move corresponding is done the item to I tab, and move corresponding header is done to I tab. So this one is overwritten with the latest one. So the second move corresponding will override the first one. So say you want to keep the first one and then append the second one in the same table, we can do that. So for that, we have to use another syntax. So the other syntax, the new syntax which we'll use now is saying keeping target lines. So it keeps you. So what will happen is, say this li item is moved to this corresponding value, and header item will also move to I tab, but it will not override it. It will append at the bottom. So let's test it. Let's test this also. All right. Check this. So the EBLN and risk are from the li item table, because these two fields are matching with the item, and these two are from the header where EBLN and Lifner. But in real project, you will not use such cases, because 45001, this PO number 1 is repeating here and also here, right? You don't want to repeat two times. So probably you want these three, say 46002 here, and here you want the Lifner and risk. So you don't want this line. So you want this Lifner to stay or be put over here. So let's see how we can do that using for and values and then doing the corresponding. Let's check that out. So that is more of a practical scenario. So we normally do not append the same data on in the final table. So we want to arrange and move the corresponding data in the corresponding fields in one row. So okay, so we'll not use move corresponding here. So what we'll use, so we will make use of the for. First we'll say itab is equal to, we'll use the value operator, value with hash. This means the value of value has, and then we have the table. All right, so this is how we do. And how do we put the value in the table? The value in the table should be in a bracket. So you have the rows over here, but how do you arrange? We want to data from li header and li item, head and item, and then they should be in one row. So my intention is to put EBLN, EBLN should be something, and in this, actually this should be one line, then Lifner should be something, and then risk should be something. But what is the value? So EBLN should come from li head or li item, I don't care, because it's available in both. And Lifner should come from header, and risk should come from item. So what I'll do, I'll loop through header. So I'll make use of the for clause. So for, say, ls head in li head. So we did one loop, so for loop, for ls head in li head. So this will loop through the first one and put it in ls head. So this is dynamic. We have not defined ls head till now. Okay, so here I can put it as ls head. What you can put? EBELN, and here we can put it as ls head here Lifner. But risk is not in header, right? So risk is not in header. So we need it to, for this header data, we need to go through item data. Okay, so let me now loop through the item. So what we'll do, we'll do the same thing for ls item. I'll make it in workplace, ls item in li item where. So just like you do the where clause in normal awk, you do the same thing where EBLN in item is equal to EBLN from header. Easy, right? Do you get it? EBLN in item is equal to EBLN in header. So why is this one crying? Oh, this is crying because now the risk we can get from ls item risk. Simple. Now activate this. So hope you understand what we did. What we did is we are trying to populate itab. In the itab we'll populate this structure, which is ebln, Lifner and risk. Where it is coming from? Since it is a value hash, the hash, if it is value hash, then the structure is dictated by the left hand side, and left hand side is itab, and itab is of type PO, TYPO. So in the TYPO you have ebln, Lifner and risk. So that's why we knew that it will be ebln, Lifner and risk. But how will the data populate? We'll populate for li header, and for the corresponding index of li header we go to li item and read ebln is will eblp and then populate the data. Let's see the output. This is the output. Isn't it beautiful? So you have all the ebln, Lifner and risk in one table, where you looped through two tables using for, and then you used a value operator using hash. All right, so hope you understand this. Okay, so let's close this guy. So here the value was with hash. So we also learned that there can be value without a hash. So in which cases it will be defined, it will be derived from the right hand side. Here the structure, this one was derived from itab. So if you want to use value, so I'll just copy this and I'll comment this guy. I'll use value without a hash. Okay, I'll say value no hash, and then I also want to get a new data, say run itab. So this one, this data I want to define in runtime, which will have ebln, Lifner and risk, but I need to tell where this structure will be referred to. So here it should have a t type, right? Remember, it should have table type PO. So table type PO we have not defined yet, so we can define it over here. So here, say I'll say types. And what was the important thing to consider? Type TO, type standard table of TYPO with what? Default keys, right? So this is very important, with default keys. So now the left hand side structure is derived from the TYPO. If you have no hash, that means this type will define the structure, what will happen in the runtime in the left hand side. So right hand side is dictating now. So now see the output. Okay, the output is error, and we know this, we had seen this earlier too. This error is because of we did a copy paste, right? So we are trying to show itab, but we have not populated itab. This time we have populated run underscore itab. So it should be run underscore itab, and now let's activate it and return. Bingo, we have the same output. So hope you understood this. So this is very important. What we did was we moved, looped through header, and then looked into item for the corresponding header PO, and then defined or populated the table, and table structure is in this case is defined by TTPO, because it is value with table type, not with value with hash. If it was value with hash, then it would have been dictated by the left hand side, but in this case is dictated by the right hand side. Hope the move corresponding for and values is clear, because this for and values you'll be using in each and every project going forward.